Hi, Theo Hannon here. I'm going to share with you a very, very quick tip and information on how you can maintain pec strength whilst going through any kind of shoulder injury syndrome. I've had shoulder impingement syndrome. I'm over it now, and I've done it in about 8 weeks in total, 10 weeks, let's say. So I'm going to share with you how we can maintain strength in the pecs, which we spent ages building up, all the bench pressing, all the pec flies, etc. Share with you exactly how we can do that without having to lift a single weight. And this is a little tip that you can use whilst you're going through an injury protocol rehabilitation, just like I've gone through, without compromising the efficacy of that rehab, because you've got to lay off the compound lifts. You've got to give that whole shoulder a complete break if you really want to build that shoulder back up so it's capable of lifting big loads in the future. So in a second, I'm going to wire myself up to an electromuscular stim unit or an EMS unit that I'm going to use to bypass my central nervous system to fire those pectoral muscles without having to do any kind of conventional isokinetic movement-based loading, which is going to preserve the integrity of those shoulder tendons whilst they rehabilitate. So give me 2 seconds. I'm just going to wire up right now. I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. Okay, so I'm all wired up here with some electrodes. I'm using a NeuroTrack XL Sports Stim Unit. This is a very cost-effective stim unit. It's about £65, which is nothing. If you're a strength athlete, you're gonna wanna invest in one of these. We're not talking $300, $400, $800 like some stim units out there. The effect is the same, okay? I mean, the contractions are very powerful. I mean, I've used this many times, especially for hamstring injuries, they're very effective. And firing up muscles that aren't firing correctly. I use it also for my shoulder impingement syndrome when I wasn't having correct firing of lower trapezius. I whacked two of these smaller electrodes on there. It got that muscle to fire up. It works, okay? It's not a replacement for isokinetic movement-based traditional weight training. You're not gonna get massive pecs. You're not gonna get an amazing set of abs from it. It's just a tool. It's just another stimulation unit that we can use to, again, move our body forward in times of injury or in times of when we need to have a different type of stimulus because we're not firing muscles correctly, etc. That's what this tool is for. It's never going to replace traditional strength training in the form of free weights and machine weights, etc., to build a great physique. It just isn't. But what we're here for is, remember, we've got shoulder impingement syndrome, we've got some kind of injury where we don't want to lose the strength in our precious pectorals that we spent years building up or whatever. And this is the way around it. Simple. Four electrodes. Forget about all the programs, set programs on here. All you need to know is maximum recruitment, maximum intensity, because what we're trying to do is maintain cross-sectional area, maintain some kind of strength. And the great thing about the stim unit and EMS, electromuscular stimulation, is it bypasses our central nervous system. It bypasses our voluntary threshold that we have in terms of recruitment, okay? This is gonna preferentially fire the fast type 2 muscle fiber above and beyond type 1 and type 2A, okay? That's what this can do. For us to do that physically, we have to go to high intensity. We have to go for the rep ranges of 1 to 4. We have to go right to the maximum to get those fast twitch fibers to fire and initiate, and that's a very time consuming and hard thing to do, and it takes a while to do it. But when you're injured, that's the last thing we're able to do, because obviously high intensity requires high loads effectively to get any kind of stimulation. This is a way around that. It's a very effective tool. Lots of athletes use it. Lots of people use it for rehabilitation. I'm going to tell you exactly what to do. You want to do 10 sets of 10 second contractions with a 50 second recovery in between each repetition. That's it. We don't want to mess around with, you know, any other modes other than perhaps maybe a pulsing mode, which is a 1 second off, 1 second on mode, which is ideal for blood flow around an injured area. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about strength, maintaining pectoral mass. You can do it. I'm going to show you what it looks like. Hopefully you'll be able to pick this up on camera. I've got this programmed up now. You can't see it, but it's got 10 minutes. So it's got 10 second contractions with a 50 second recovery. Now you can control the voltage and the current that's going in there. And you can also control the rest and ramp up times. That's just down to your own personal preference. All you need to know is we need to fire these puppies up as strong as possible. Allow the 50 second recovery. Do it 3 times a week. About 10 to 15 sessions will be sufficient to maintain any kind of strength and even improve strength in this particular exercise. And that should be just about enough time whilst your shoulder rehabilitates. Around 3 months' time should be good enough. I mean, I'm already there, and it's a good way of doing it, okay? So I'm gonna turn it on, and we're gonna give it a shot, okay? And hopefully you're gonna see the pecs slowly contract, okay? I'm just cranking it up to strong. Now you can see the right one. And now I'm just pumping up the left one, okay? So you can actually see there is a strong contraction. And that's quite painful now. So that's about 40% of the limit of what this thing is on. Now you just saw that release. It works, you will get sore from it. It's not gonna replace any other thing that's out there. It's not a wonder tool or anything like that. It's just a tool. We have the ability to use these things. Why wouldn't you use them? And I've used them very successfully through many injuries, many issues when you've got one muscle not firing than the other one is and all those kind of things. This is a great, great, simple tool. You can use it all the time. You can use it in conjunction with weight training as well. And it's just a great tool to use. So the link below this video will take you to a more extensive information on this week and buy, etc., on my blog. And well, now you know how to stimulate your pectorals going through any kind of shoulder injury. And there they go again, all right? So I'll see you later.